at that. I have these particles kind of moving along here. They're repelling from each other if they're too close.
So the physics kind of done by the trainer particles. Now you're going to move on to actually building the neural networks that are going to learn from these particles, right? Simon?
Yeah. 20 is really small distance. Let's make that distance a little bit larger, like 50.
Are they repelled from each other? From one another?
Yeah.
And what are they going to teach your particle? The learning particle. Or are there going to be many learning particles?
They're going to be they're not particles. They're going to be perceptrons.
Perceptrons.
Classifying points that are on one side of the line or on the other. And by the way, I'm going to make them stop moving. If they are...
But what is correct? What is going to be correct and what is going to be incorrect?
I don't know, because it's gonna guess. It's gonna... So you can see I have these particles kind of experiencing physics here. They're kind of bouncing, they're kind of... Because these are bouncing. They're kind of bouncing. They're bouncing off of each other. And you can see they're bouncing off. You see they're bouncing. Are bouncing. I just want them to be even. I just wanted them to not overlap. So that's why they're moving and doing all their weird flashy stuff.
And what are you going to do to build the perceptrons?
First, so in the video, I actually have these weights here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I want an activation function.
Okay.
So I'm just gonna put that here, activate. Okay, so you can see I have this activation function now. I just put By the way, I think there is something in the math object in Java called sine, which actually just does all this. There's a function in math called sine.
Mm-hmm.
This is a nicer way of doing it. Then I want a function called feedforward. With some inputs. So this function is gonna guess an output. This is gonna make the perceptron guess. Hey, guessing perceptron. Okay, so there we go. So first I need a weighted sum. So you can see I have this thing now. I'm gonna say a sum plus equals inputs index I plus weights. Oh, sorry, times weights. Index I, right? And that weighted sum is gonna get passed through this activation function. So we'll return activate sum. Look at that. And this is gonna make the perceptron. This is going to ask the perceptron to guess.
But there are going to be two perceptrons, right?
Yeah.
This is the first one, or both of them?
This is both of them.
Okay.
Okay, I'm going to say a perceptron. Perceptron. I'm going to make a perceptron. Perceptron. And call this brain. Brain. Brain equals a new perceptron. Perceptron. Inputs. I'm going to make some inputs equals, you know, negative 1, 0.5. And I'm gonna say int gets equals brain dot feed forward inputs. I'm gonna ask the perceptron to guess. And then I'm just gonna say a print line guess. Oh, and I need to say perceptron 2, right? Right, they're just two inputs. You see, I got a negative 1. Negative 1.
Don't shake my phone.
Look, I got a negative
one. Show with your finger on the screen. I don't see anything.
Here.
There's an arrow. What does that mean?
The perceptron guessed a negative one.
What does that mean that it guessed a negative one?
Eventually,
a one.
Well, to run a bunch of times, and I got a positive
one. No, but what does it mean? Is negative one or positive one that's on either side of the line?
Above means positive one, and below means negative one.
But is there also correct and incorrect? Is negative one not good and one is good, or
is it what
is it gonna learn?
Should a little table on the whiteboard.
Okay, great. So, yeah.
Okay, so what am I going to? So.
Да, конечно.
I'm gonna show you a little table. If it's supposed to be a negative one, I could guess a negative one or a plus one. If it's supposed to be a plus one, I could guess a negative one or a plus one. So there are only three possible errors. 0, -2, and +2. Right?
Okay.
Right? There is a guess. Guess? If it's supposed to be a negative one, if I guess a negative one, and if it's supposed to be a negative one, right? What is that?
Then it's a correct answer.
Then the error is right, -1 - -1?
-2.
No. -1 - -1.
Ah, it's 0.
That error is 0. Is it? If it's supposed to be a negative one, but I guess a plus one, that error, right? It's -1 - +1.
That's -2.
Right? That's -2. If it's supposed to be a plus one, but I guessed a negative one. -1 - -1? It's a +2.
But I thought you can only guess above or below the line. I didn't even know there was an option of guessing -2, -2, or 2, or 0. I thought the only two options were -1 or 1.
That's actually true. These are errors.
Yeah.
And then 1 - 1, that
is 0.
Is 0. So maybe I should write that up here. Maybe I should write that here. Answer. Guess. And error.
I suggest that we maybe stop this video now, and then we make another one when you're further in the project.
Yeah. Okay, so... First let me show you the training process.
Okay. All right.
Step one is... Provide the perceptron for provide the perceptron with a known answer.
Okay.
Provide the perceptron a known answer. What? How do you say that?
You can say both.
With a known answer. Since one of these, that's the answer. Step two is ask the perceptron.